and welcome to the first episode of our new panel show, The Debate. I'm your host, Joe Kelly. Today we're joined by candidates for the Salford and Eccles constituency in the upcoming general election. Let's meet the candidates fighting out for your vote. Today, we'll be asking a deceptively simple question. Whose responsibility is the climate? Is the United Kingdom facing a democratic crisis? The word democracy derives from ancient Greek. Demos meaning people and kratos meaning power. But how much power is really in the hands of the people? Today we will explore what effect the Brexit referendum and subsequent toing and froing has had on our democracy. With all sides of the debate invoking the principle of democracy, whom are we really to believe? According to Freedom House's 2019 study, Freedom in the World, the UK is extremely democratic, attaining a maximum score. But is that the whole story? And have recent years had a damaging effect? Let's begin with the referendum itself. On the 23rd of June 2016, the United Kingdom voted to leave the European Union by a margin of 51.9 to 48.1%. And let's begin by talking about direct democracy. We'll start with you, Graham. Since 2010, the British people has been asked to have its say on some pretty fundamental constitutional questions. We've had Scottish independence referendum, the electoral reform, and also EU membership. Are we not living in the most democratic time in this
nation? Well, in some ways.
Chris asks, I run an online business with a significant EU customer base who would be inconvenienced and receive additional charges if free movement of goods between the UK and the EU were to cease post-Brexit. Can you all explain the benefit of Brexit to me and my business and what you intend to do to prevent the cessation of the freedom of movement of goods? And we'll start with Rebecca Long-Bailey on this. Your party has come under a lot of criticism for its Brexit policy. So, in response to Chris, whether it's a Labour deal or Remain after a people's vote, is free trade inevitable?
It actually just asked a far too simplistic question.
Yes, but it asked without the question actually
we'll come later to how the question was phrased and how that should be acted upon. But even from this brief discussion at the start, we can see that even the question of having a referendum is polarising. And I wanted to touch upon polarisation within the referendum first. We'll come back to you, Graham.
Joel, you did say in your opening statement there that the sort of actual, the power of each individual, particularly from poorer backgrounds, is fairly minimal, and we do need some sort of societal change. Do we sort of agree then that most people are going about their day-to-day lives and don't perhaps have the luxury to enact changes that they would like to?
Claire's brought up this notion of demonisation. Is there another side to that story when we go to the look at the referendum question, as we briefly mentioned before? When people went into the ballot boxes, did they know exactly what they were voting for, be it Remain or Leave, John? One of the criticisms is of the Commission that initiates legislation that is nominated by the member states. Is it as simple as, if you can't vote them out, it's not democratic? Or does it go a lot deeper than that? Excellent. I can see Rebecca furiously taking down notes, so let's see what she's...
Can I just remind the Labour Party?
Well, unfortunately, that's all we have time for. I'd like to thank our guests, John Leach, Claire Fox and Sir Graham Brady, for joining us today. We'll be back on your screens on the 28th of November for our general election special, in which we'll be putting candidates for the Salford and Eccles constituency under the spotlight. Thanks for joining us and see you next time.